In this lab, we'll look at using network access protection. After completing the lab, we'll be able to configure NAT for DHCP, configure NAT for VPNs, and configure NAT for IPsec. In our first exercise, we will configure network access protection for DHCP and then test the settings on a NAT client. Our principal task for the exercise will be to enable the client settings, configure the NAT server settings, configure NAT policies, configure DHCP, and finally test client access. Okay, so from our client machine, let's go into control panel, and we want to look at system and maintenance, administrative tools, and we'll double click services. Now the service we're looking for is Network Access Protection Agent. And what we want to do is we want to change the startup type from manual to automatic. So we're okay that. And we'll close down our windows. Now with that done, we want to open up our Network Access Protection Client Configurator. And that's done entering the command NAP clcfg.msc. Okay, we're into the console and we'll click on Enforcement Clients and we want to enable DHCP Quarantine Enforcement Client. And with that done, we'll restart the computer. Okay, with that rebooting, we'll go into our Network Policy Server and we're going to configure the NAP server settings. So we'll go to the Network Policy Server console. And from there, we'll expand Network Access Protection, System Health Validators, and we're going to click on Windows Security Health Validator. From here, we can configure, and we're going to choose to make sure that a firewall is enabled and automatic updates are enabled. And we can do that for XP and Vista. So we're okay there, and that's now configured. Now what we want to do is click on Health Policies, and we're going to create a new health policy. And we want to call this one Compliant, and we're going to use a Windows Security Health Validator. And we just create a new one called Non-Compliant. Again, selecting the Windows Security Health Validator SHV. Okay, we've got our two health policies. Now the network policies, we're going to enable our connection to Microsoft Root and Remote Access, and also connections to Remote Access servers. We'll create a new network policy, and we'll call this one DHCP Compliant Full Access. We're going to select DHCP Server for the Network Access Server, and we're going to add a condition in. We're going to select NAP capable computers and only respond to computers that are NAP capable. And we're going to add a new policy, or a new condition, should I say. And we're going to add health policy, and we're going to select compliant. We'll next for our wizard, we'll leave it access granted, and we're going to make sure that all we do is perform a health check. Okay, we'll next through the rest of the wizard and hit finish. We see that that's now enabled, so let's go ahead and create a non-compliant one. So DHCP, non-compliant, restrict access. Again, we're going to choose DHCP server. Again, we're going to add a condition to what NAP capable computers only. And we're at our health policy. this time choosing non-compliant. And next through the wizard, we'll have access granted, again only doing a health check. But this time we will configure some settings. So we want NAP enforcement. We're going to allow limited access. And we're going to create a new remediation server group. So we'll add a new server into the remediation group. And we'll type in the IP address 192.168.16.4. We'll give it a troubleshooting URL. Now what this will do is give instructions to users on how to bring their computers and devices into compliance with this access policy. So we'll point it to web.restricted.contoso.com troubleshooting. And we'll next and finish the wizard. Okay, we'll minimize this. And from administrative tools, we're going to go to DHCP. And we're going to create a new scope. So we give it a name. We'll call it NAP scope. And we give it a start address and an end address. So 192.168.16.150 to 192.168.16.200. We won't have any exclusions, we'll use the default lease time, and we choose not to configure any options at this time. If I expand the scope and activate, and then go into the properties of the scope, we're going to enable network access protection for it. Now under scope options, I'm going to configure some options. Under advanced, first thing I want to configure is a DNS server, and I'll type the IP address in. So 192.168.16.1. And we're going to add a DNS name. And we'll call this contoso.com. We'll then choose default NAP health clients, and again DNS servers 192.168.16.1, but this time we will change the 015 DNS domain name to restricted.contoso.com. And we're okay that. Back onto our client machine, let's go ahead and test these settings. So we'll log on as an administrator. And in control panel, under security, we're going to turn the Windows firewall off. So we'll turn it to off and we'll hit OK. And we'll open up a command prompt, and if we do an IP config, we can see that our machine's non-compliant, so it's in the restricted domain. If we fix our firewall, firewall is enabled again. And if we now go back into our command prompt, we can instantly see that the computer meets the requirements. And IP config again should see our new settings. In this exercise, we'll configure network access protection for VPN and then test the settings on a NAP client. The principal task for this exercise will be to configure routing and remote access settings, configure a connection request policy, configure network policies, and then configure client settings and test the VPN connection. Okay, so let's open up Server Manager. And from Server Manager, what we will do is we will configure and enable routing and remote access. And run through the wizard. We're going to turn it into a VPN server. We select our VPN interface. And we're going to choose from a specified range of addresses for DHCP. And we're typing our IP address range of 192.168.16.201 to 192.168.16.210. Right next to this, we choose not to use a radius server at this time and finish the wizard. Read the warning signs. And we'll start the service. Okay, we're now installed. Let's go into our network policy server. Click on policies. Let's clean up our box a bit. And we'll do a new connection request policy. So we give it a name as VPN. And we'll choose remote access server, VPN dial-up. And add our condition. The first condition that we want to add is going to be day and time restrictions, and we're going to permit it at any time. We're going to add an authentication method, and we're going to use protected EAP, and we'll finish that. Under network policies, we'll do a new network policy, and we're going to call this one VPS compliant. And we're going to give it full access. And again, we're going to choose remote access server, VPN dial-up. We're going to add a condition. We're going to add a NAP-capable computer. And a health policy. Say compliant. And we're next through the wizard. And again, we'll create one more network policy. We call this VPN non-compliant restricted access. Again, selecting remote access server VPN dial-up, and we're at our conditions. So NAP-capable computers only. And if we scroll down, we'll do health policies, this time selecting non-compliant. Okay, we're going to choose NAP enforcement. And from here, we're going to allow limited access. And for an IP filter, we're going to add a new input filter. We choose the destination network address of 192.168.16.1. And we're going to permit only the packets listed below, and we'll put a new output filter in. For the source network, 192.168.16.1. And we're okay that, and again permit only those packets. We'll finish the wizard and connect up to our client machine. Now from here we're going to go into our NAP client configurator and open up the security console, and under enforcement clients we're going to right click remote access quarantine and enable it. From here in network, we're going to go into properties and open up our network and sharing center and set up a new connection connecting to our workplace. We're going to use an internet connection, but set it up later and enter the internet address of 10.0.10.1. We give it a destination name of Contoso VPN, and next we're the wizard. We click on connect to a network, we can see Contoso VPN. From there we're going to properties, and we're going to choose advanced security settings, and we're going to choose to use protected EAP. I'm not going to validate the certificate, but we're going to enable quarantine checks. And we'll hit connect. We'll type in our user credentials. And our domain. We can see we're authenticated to the network. If I go to the control panel and once more turn off my firewall, we should see that we're no longer compliant. In our final exercises of the lab, we'll configure network access protection for IPsec and then test the settings on a NAP client. Our principal task for this exercise will be to enable an exemption group, configure certificate settings, configure the default domain policy, configure NAP settings, and finally configure client settings and verify NAP functionality. Okay, so on our domain controller, we'll go into Server Manager. And what we want to do is create a new group in Active Directory Users and Computers. So expand Active Directory Domain Services, Active Directory Users and Computers, contoso.com, and we'll right click and create a new group. And we want to call this group IPsec NAP Exemption. We're okay that. And go into the properties of the group and add the MPS server. So we'll click on object type, selecting computers, and from there type in SEA MPS 001. Check our names and OK. And OK. What we'll do is we'll now go into Active Directory Certificate Services. And we'll click on certificate templates and we'll copy a template for a new health policy. So we'll copy workstation authentication, we'll duplicate it for server 2003 and above, and we'll give it a new template display name of system health authentication. We're going to publish the certificate in Active Directory and click on extensions. Now if we edit the policy, we're going to add a new application policy. And we'll give it a name of System Health Authentication. And we'll enter a new object identifier. And we hit OK. So we'll do is click on Security and we'll add. We're going to add our new group in. And we give them the ability to enroll and auto-enroll. If I now expand our certificate authority, and we're going to enable the certificate template, and we can now see that it's in there. Gaining security. We're going to add network services and enable the permissions for initial issue and manage certificates. Okay, back in Server Manager under Certification Authority, we're going to go into the properties and we're going to use an Enterprise CA. We're going to use compliant templates. And from there, go into a custom MMC console. And we're going to add the snap in, choosing certificates for the computer account. So if we expand certificates, local computer, expand personal, click on certificates, we can see we've got a certificate there already, but we're going to request a new one. And we're going to select a system health authentication certificate. We can see that that's successfully enrolled. Close out the console without saving. And we're going to connect up to our domain controller. Now from our domain controller, we want to select group policy management. And from there, we edit our default domain policy. Now under computer configuration policies, Windows settings, security settings, going to click on public key policies. And from there, we're going to click on the certificate service client and we're going to enable it. We're going to choose to renew expired certificates. And then from our policy server, we're going to go ahead and configure NAP. We're going to choose how we're going to connect. So we're going to use the Health Registration Authority. We're picking our health validator. And we've finished the wizard. From our client machine, we're going to go into network properties. We're going to manage network connections. We're going to choose to disable the virtual private network. And again, we're going to go into NAP Client Configurator. Once we're in the console under Enforcement Clients, we're going to select IPsec Relaying Policy. And we're going to select our Trusted Server Groups, creating a new one. Call it Trusted HRA Servers. And we'll type in the URL of HTTP CMPS001.contoso.com. The main HRA, I'm going to finish off that URL. From a command prompt then, we'll do a GP update and we'll force it. And we'll next up our NAP agent and we'll start it again. From here we're going to an MMC console, we'll add remove snapping, and we'll add certificates for the computer account, local machine. If we expand that, click on certificates, let's turn Windows Firewall off. We see it doesn't meet the requirements of the network. What we should see is our certificate is revoked. So if we refresh, we can see the certificate has gone. If we turn that back on and become compliant again, we should see the certificate come back.